There is so much talk about smart cities, but what about smart water? I'm not talking about the trending bottles people are carrying around. I'm talking about smart technology to redesign clean water management and distribution. Smart water sensors are the most proactive and accessible way to stem water waste and facilitate conservation. Just in the US, water utilities are predicted to invest $8.3 billion in smart infrastructure over the next 10 years. While countries have increased their budgets for water, sanitation, and hygiene, 80% of countries have reported that the increase is still insufficient to meet nationally defined targets for those services. The recent water emergency in Cape Town is just the latest in a string of crises that have pushed major cities to the brink of running out of clean drinking water.
I have been monitoring Cape Town, and it's a tragic situation. But what we are seeing is the agility of that culture to say, okay, we need to get to grips with this. It may well be that Cape Town becomes a leader in how to deploy resilience around water supply in smart cities.
And if you're saying, wait, Cape Town is a smart city, so how did they run out of water? You'd be asking a great question. Not all smart cities have focused on smart water solutions and sensors to improve water infrastructure and consumption issues. Cape Town ignored major warning signs 2 decades ago and is just now looking at smart water solutions to address these problems.
I would suggest that smart water cities haven't been talked about that much is because the mindset is, well, what's the ROI? And that's a single bottom line mindset. What the world's moving to is a triple bottom line mindset, which is about making money, which is good, but also about environmental impact and social impact.
Advanced clean water management for cities is a global trend. Some of the most populated cities in the world have faced or are preparing for water shortages. This also means that water sensors are going to be in high demand. Water quality monitoring will grow at a compound annual rate of close to 7% by 2022. Here's the kicker. According to estimates by the World Bank, investments in infrastructure need to triple to $114 billion per year, a figure which does not include operating and maintenance costs. And delaying action could be catastrophic not only for human health, but for the environment and the economy. Water scarcity, exacerbated by climate change, could cost some regions up to 6% of their GDP, spur migration, and spark conflict. In Cape Town, businesses that rely on fresh water are faced with the option of either creating their own clean water infrastructure or closing. But now that cities and countries are on the verge of running out of clean water, investment in infrastructure and clean water technology is inevitable. It should be, since humans will die otherwise, and consumption is not slowing down. I'm Tamara Lane, and this is Karma.